we are going to represent decimal as a fraction. First we will start with terminating decimals. 0.5, 0.12, 0.07, 0.56. Here we see there is one digit after decimal. It can be written as 5 upon 1. We can cancel it and write it in lowest term, 1/12. This we have two digits after decimal. There is 0. It will be written as 12 upon 2. Now we can write it in lowest term by dividing both by 4. 3 is 25. It will be written as 3 upon 25. 0.07, again 2 digits after decimal. It will be written as 7 upon 100. If you write 0.7, it will be same. And now we can write it out like this. We have 0.56. We can write it as 56 upon 100. Now we will write it in lowest term. Here, if we divide it by 4, we get 14. Divided by 4, we get 35. 14 upon 30. In all these examples, we have 0 before decimal. So we are getting all the fractions as proper fraction. Now we will take some examples where we have this whole number part other than 0. Now, suppose we have 3.4. 12.6, 3.05, 4.125. Here, this can be written as 34 upon 10. We can divide and write them in lowest term. 2 5 and 2 17 upon 5. Now we can divide 17 by 5 and write it in mixed fraction. 5 3 are 15 and 2. 15 plus 2, 17. 5 3 are 15 plus 2, 17. In this way, it can be written like this. We can write it in another way also. Let us see here. 3.4 we have. We can write it as 3, 4 by 10. One digit after decimal, this can be written as 4 upon 10. Now, 2 to your 4, 2, 5 by 10. 3, whole number, 2 upon 10. Same answer we are getting. Now, let us see 12.6. 6 upon 10, it can be written as like this. Now, we can divide both by 2, 2, 3 here, 2, 5 here. 12 whole number, 3 upon 5. This can be written as 3, 5 upon 100. Since there are two digits after decimal, there is no value of 0 if you write here. 5 1 is 5, 20 is 100. So it becomes 3 whole number, 1 by 20. Now this can be written as 4, 1, 25. There are three digits after decimal. So we can write it like this. We can cancel 125 1 jar, 125 8 jar. 4, 1. 4 whole number, 1 upon 8. Now, if we have whole number part other than 0, then the fraction will be mixed number, or here we get improper fraction. Like this. Now, we are going to, all these were example of terminating decimals. Now we are going to see how we can write non-terminating regular decimals as a fraction. Let us take an example, simple example, 0.8. This. We have x is equal to 0.8 bar. It can be written as 0.88 and so on. It has no error. Let us take an edge equation bar. Since one digit is being repeated, we will multiply both sides by 10. Let it be equation 2. Now we will subtract equation first from second. Equation 2 minus equation 1. 10x minus x, we will get 9x. And this 8.88 minus 0.88, we will get 8.0 or simply 8. It will become x is equal to 8 upon 9. Here, I want to show this 8.888 and so on, 0.888 and so on, 0, 0, 0 and 8. We have got this. 9x is equal to 8, therefore x is equal to 8 upon 9. This is the fraction of this decimal. Now we will take another example. Suppose we have been given number 0.17. Now there are two digits, bar over two digits, so it will become 0.17, 17, 17 and so on. Let it be equation 1. Now we will multiply both sides by 100 since two digits are repeated here. Multiply both sides by 100. Now it will become 100x is equal to 17.1717 and so on. Let it be equation 2. Now we will subtract again equation 1 from 2. 2 minus 1. Equation 2 minus 1. 100x minus, you can write it here, 100x minus x. This is equal to 17.1717 and so on, minus 0.1717 and so on. 100x minus x, we will get 99x. And this minus this, we will get 17 here. Then x is equal to 17 upon 99. Hence, 0.17 is equal to 17 upon 99. This is the fraction representation of this decimal. In this way, if there are differing over three digits, we will multiply both sides by 1000. In this way, we can represent some decimal numbers into fraction.